What's up, guys? Got another holster to share with you. This is a G-Code holster. This particular model is the XST model, and they're manufactured by Edgeworks out of Jacksonville, North Carolina. They do have a website. It's www.range5.com. For those of you who are interested in pricing and some more specifics, they also have a lot of accessories for these. this particular model is an all kydex body model. Okay, even the strap here is made of kydex. Now this may look like a level 3 holster, but it's but I consider it a level 2 holster, meaning that the tension of the holster itself is adjustable, and that's one form of retention. Also the strap here, that's a second form. So I consider this a level 2 holster. Well, before we get started, let's just safety clear this. Okay. This particular one is for my Glock 17. Okay. And I think one of the most important things with kydex holsters is that it's got to be pretty much form fitted to your gun. And this one just slips in and it's snug. Okay. Just no shaking, no rattling at all with this holster. Just very, very solid. Now I don't know how many of you are used to carrying a holster with this type of mechanism, this release mechanism. Okay. But if you see how big this thumb release is, okay. It's almost a natural way to draw your weapon. As you're coming in, or as this is the way that I was doing it, and I found it to be a very natural, very fluid motion. So as I'm coming in to draw my weapon, I use this as an index. Okay. And actually, most of the time when I'm drawing, my thumb actually hits this and it releases it, you know, just naturally. Coming in, using my thumb to pull my weapon out, and I have a full combat grip. There is nothing to change, and you're ready to shoot. That's why I love this holster so much. It's you know, I've always done concealed carry holsters. I've had many holsters specifically for defensive handgun courses and some other courses, but I really wasn't happy with them, with the majority of them. Now this holster here really changed my mind, just because, you know, the pricing is right, the materials are great, you know, kydex materials. I think the this piece here is a glass filled polymer. Okay, even the hardware here, this looks like it's galvanized, maybe, but it's weatherproof and just very solid platform. You know, the spring housing, the spring is actually housed inside of the main assembly here. Okay, so it's not gonna get affected by weather too much, but just a very one solidly built holster. I'll show you the front of it. I'm not pointing at this at my face. This is the camera set about 2.5 feet, 3 feet from my face right now, so it's actually pointing at the camera, not me. Okay, and you can see the clearance here. If you have aftermarket sights, it should clear most aftermarket sights. Okay, I'll give you a view of it here. You can see there's plenty of room to clear just about every aftermarket sight out there. I'm not sure about the big dot sights, but it will clear the majority of aftermarket sights out there. Okay. Now, what I also love about this holster is it's basically completely modular. The mounting platform that I chose was this here, and this is fitted for MOLLE attachments. Okay, now The belt that I'm wearing is a Molly belt, but there's a 1-in-7 or 1-3/4 inch web belt that runs through it, and I've used it on here, and it holds it very tight, very snug, and it's not moving. And the way this gets mounted here is these screws that protrude out correspond to these holes here, and they just slide on and it locks. Okay, and it's not going anywhere. It's extremely solid platform. Okay, to release this, you have two little nubs back here. You just squeeze those together and it pops out. If you can hear that spring, whatever it's controlled, I think it's mainly a tension, not a spring. But once you release that, this pops right out. Now this is great for many reasons. You can actually go to their website and you can purchase different types of mounting options. You can have a paddle option, you can have a slide-on belt option. They also sell this round piece here. Okay, now I was going to order, actually I am going to order just the single piece here. If you notice these rivet holes here, okay, you can actually screw this round piece onto the inside of a pickup truck, you know, the cabin, and you can easily mount this pistol in there. Okay, a lot of different options in mounting. You can mount this underneath the desk, okay, and have your pistol ready to go. And then when you're getting ready to leave, take your pistol with you with the holster. Okay, it just has so many very many different options that you're able to do with this. Now I'm gonna show you what it looks like on my belt and how it sits, but just give me a minute and we'll do that. Alright, so here's what it looks like mounted on my belt. Now this particular belt is made by US Grunt Gear. I could do a review on that. But as you can see, I do have Molly attachments here, but on my particular belt, on my right hand side, it has this 1-3/4 inch, just very thick webbing. Okay, and I decided to mount it on here, and it's solid. It's not moving side to side, it's not moving up and down. Now the way I have it mounted is between one of the stitchings, so these two flanges here go between the stitching. But even if I wanted to mount it on an open spot, the way they design this, it's not gonna move side to side at all. It's not gonna twist, so it's a very, very solid mount. And I'm going to show you, this may look like it sticks out just way too far. Okay, let me put that on here. Okay. But there's a reason, and it's a pretty good reason, and it's another option also. Now, if you're wearing this belt and you're wearing body armor, or you have a chest rig, this will clear it. This will clear all your body armor and your chest rig. So that's a very good option to have, but it doesn't stick out so far that if you're not wearing it, it's awkward to draw. So that's what it looks like mounted on my particular belt. And I'll go ahead and wear it and show you how it sits. As you can see there, you still have clearance if you were to wear body armor or some sort of chest rig over this. You still have that clearance, okay. And again, drawing it is very natural and it's very fluid. Again, I index using this portion of the Kydex strap, index it with that, and it comes right out. Okay. So very, very natural, very easy a draw style. And it doesn't take any more time than if you didn't have the strap on. I shouldn't say that, but so basically that's how it looks. Okay. Again, very easy, very natural fluid movement to draw your weapon. Get a closer view of that. Okay. Again, full combat grip as soon as you're drawing it. You still have that full retention. It's not coming out. The mount on it, as you can see there, it's not moving side to side. That's actually my belt that's moving. Okay. A very natural draw. And that's the way it looks. So I think overall I'm extremely happy with the G-Code holsters. I do have another one to share with you. I'll probably make a separate video of it. It is slightly different in design, and you do have some more options that you don't have with this particular model. So if you're interested, go to range5.com. And again, this is an American company, so you know, I always try and support American-made products and companies. Also, one last thing is the price is extremely right for the quality that you get, the tolerances and the materials. You just can't really beat the price. Now, you know, there are some other Kydex holster manufacturers out there, but I think they're just really lackluster in just quality. So, you know, again, extremely happy with it. I hope this video helped out for guys looking for some tactical or law enforcement guys, military guys, that are looking for a good quality tactical holster that has some really cool options. So if you got any questions, you know, just leave them down below, rate and comment as usual, and thank you.